Hey guys, BlowJLeader here, and welcome to my first top 10 video. That's right, I'm stepping into the world of top 10 videos. Don't worry, this won't become a thing on my channel. I'll only be doing top 10 videos if I feel I need to share an opinion that's important. Unlike some other YouTube channels, this list will be judged on how good I think the characters are and what episodes they were in. So without further ado, let's get started with the video. Number 10. Douglas. And only Douglas. I mean, I like Donald too, but I think Douglas is just a lot better, character-wise. Donald and Douglas are some of the best twins in the TV show. They've got some interesting personalities, great episodes. They're basically great characters in general. But I like Douglas a lot more because he's just a bit more of the heroic type. Like, he smashed a brake van. He saved Oliver from scrap. He's just done a lot more heroic things, and he has a bit slightly more interesting backstory than his brother. Like, he was gonna be scrapped if he didn't go along with Donald. I think that's a bit more interesting, and I mean, he's a bit more of the jokey type compared to Donald. Donald's a bit more of the kinder one, which, I mean, it works in its own way, but I think Douglas is just a bit more interesting. I am glad the twins are back in the CG series, but I wish each one could get like their own solo episode. I think that might be pretty interesting. So yeah, I think Douglas is a pretty fitting engine for the number 10 spot on this list. Number 9. Boko. I've always kind of liked Boko because he was one of those nice diesels and he's kind of has a bit more layer to him than what meets the eye. He doesn't really appear that much in the TV series, which is a shame because I feel like he has a lot of potential. Like, he works really well with Bill and Ben, and he's good friends with Edward, so I feel like it might be nice to see an episode with them all together again, kind of like the old days. He's a character I just want to see. I don't really have any reason. He's just a character I want to see return. I feel like he's got potential, and I guess that's kind of the main reason I like him. He's just got a lot of potential. Like, he's a nice diesel, but we've seen, like, other people do cool stuff with him. And that's kind of what I want to see. I think he's just a really cool character, and just got to see more of him. A nice diesel who I just want to see more of. Number 8. Rusty and Duncan. I put these two in the same spot because of their relationship with each other, but we'll get to that in a minute. First off, Rusty. Rusty is like if you took the heroic side of Douglas and then took the kind diesel side of Boko. And it works really well. He has a lot of great episodes, and he's just a nice guy. He's kind of like the do-it-right guy of the narrow-gauge engines. He knows what to do, and he has a pretty cool job of keeping maintenance of the railway. But what makes Rusty a whole lot better is Duncan. Duncan is the rebel of the narrow-gauge engines. He always likes to do things his way, but he always ends up in trouble in some sort of way or another. But this is why I like him working off with Rusty. They can either be really nice to each other or be at each other's throats, and it's still great all the same. They've just got such a good dynamic that they just become instant favorites of mine. Whenever they're in an episode with each other, I just enjoy to see them, which is why I think these both deserve the number 8 spot on this list. Number 7. Toby. I've always liked his episodes as a kid. Whether he was on his old branch line, or if he was riding down a flooding river, he was just always a joy to watch. I liked his relationship with Thomas and Percy, and I do like his personality. He's an old-fashioned engine, but he's still got a lot to him. Well, that's not how the current TV show sees him as. He barely appears in the CGI series. He has a couple of episodes dedicated to him, and even then, sometimes it's just a small cameo and that's it. I can't believe they're even calling him a main character now when they just don't even treat him like one. And it's a shame because, again, he can have a lot of potential for different episodes. Just watch my episodes and you'll completely understand what I'm talking about. So yeah, it is kind of disappointing that he is a little underused, but just because he's old-fashioned doesn't mean he's a grand engine for number 7. Number 6. Oliver and Toad. put together again because of their relationship, but we'll get to that later. Anyway, first, Oliver. Oliver has hands down one of the best backstories out of any of the Asians. He had to be saved from scrap, and he looks like he's been through a lot, which is just a nice touch. But even then, he's not just a nice engine who had to be saved, he has a lot more personality. He's a strong engine who doesn't take any nonsense from the trucks, and I just like that about him. I'm glad he's back in the CGI series, and especially with his Braid fan Toad. Toad is like the Mr. Nice guy. He tries to be really polite, like he'll always say Mr. before any other name, and it's just really cute. He also has some of the best episodes, whether he's running down a hill with a truck, or if he's flying into a snowbank, or even having his own adventure. He's definitely one of the coolest characters to return, and I can understand why he has some of his own episodes in the TV show. I also like the relationship. Oliver's always kind of leading him, but then Toad's trying to be nice at the same time. It's just kind of cute how they work off with each other. I'd say I maybe like Toad a little bit more, but I put them both on here because, well, I kind of like them all the same. So I guess that's all I really need to say. I think Oliver and Toad are perfect contenders for number 6 on this list. Number 5. Percy. Fun fact, Percy was actually my favorite character as a kid. And while that's changed, I still really like him. He has a lot of the great episodes. Whether he's taking a plunge, getting trousers around his funnel, or even getting buried by an avalanche, he has some of the best crashes in the TV series. I love his personality. He's a cheeky engine, but he's still a good friend. In the new series, he's kind of wimped down, like he's now always nervous and timid, which I don't feel like that really shines Percy's character as much as it could be. But I still like Percy all the same, and I just had to keep him somewhere on this list. Number 4. Henry. Who am I kidding? Everybody loves Henry, and I do too. First off, his personality. He's kind, but can be rather arrogant sometimes. And I think that's a rather relatable personality. We all try to be that nice person, but we even can't get in the way of our arrogance. I think that's kind of a neat message to teach kids. But he also has some of the greatest episodes in the TV show ever. Like Henry Special Cole, The Flying Kipper, Henry and the Elephant, Whistles and Sneezes, Haunted Henry, too much to list. He also goes through a lot of relatable experiences. Like when he's having problems and it seems like no one cares, you can really feel the emotion. And when he goes through the big crash, you really feel it. And what I think what makes people appreciate Henry more is how much he's changed throughout the series. Like, he was kind of turned into a goody-goody engine who really needed his special coal in the new series. And in the CGI series, while they kind of improved him, they also made him a little bit wimpy at the same time, which I think that got a lot of fans mad who really loved Henry. It just seems the TV show doesn't really like Henry that much. But even then, the fans can still like him, and I do too, which is why he's number 4 on my list. Number 3. Diesel 10. Diesel 10 is, in my opinion, the perfect depiction of a train villain. He's big, bad, and menacing, but not scary. He also has a ton of funny moments, like when he interacts with Splatter and Dodge, and when he gets the coal dumped over him when he's like, "Just stop being so stupid." It's just funny. I don't really see him being bad all the time, which I think is why he's mellowed down in the new series, but good god, they suck the joy out of this character. He is just not interesting. He's just kind of a nice-ish Diesel who's just kind of a bully. He's just not interesting anymore. But oh well, at least we still have Thomas and the Magic Railroad. We may never see Diesel 10 in his true form, but you know what? It just makes us respect the Magic Railroad version all the same. And that's why he's number 3 on my list. Number 2. James. Fun fact, James has always been my second favorite character, even as a kid. And for good reasons too. To sum up his character in a nutshell, he's vain and boastful, but can be alright from time to time. But this allows him for some pretty fun interactions with the other characters. Like if he's with Henry or Gordon, he'll act like the boss, he'll be like, "Oh, I'm a cool guy." But if he's hanging out with Thomas, Percy, or Edward, he'll be like, I don't really like you guys." This makes for some pretty fun episodes at the same time. And speaking of episodes, he has some of the best in the series. Like his 3-part trilogy in season 1, James in a Mess, Old Iron, All in Vain, and James II Bess, and the list just goes on and on. But what makes James so much cooler is that he has a bit more layers to him than just being vain. Like, he can be determined sometimes, and even kind of the other engines. I also like that he originally had black paint. This makes his red paint all the more special to him and why he doesn't want it to get dirty. I've just always really liked James, and a lot of people do. I know a couple of people who don't really like James because they think he's kind of a big shot, like, oh, cool, popular kid. But honestly, I don't find that really a big reason to dislike him. So I've always really liked James, and who better for the number two spot on this list? And before we get to number one, I'd like to go over one honorable mention, and that goes to none other than Thomas the Tank Engine. Yeah, kind of a generic pick, but that's why he didn't make the list. But let's be real, if Thomas never existed, we might have never had a TV show. Yeah, he's kind of overused and a little bit ridiculous in the TV show nowadays. But again, if we never had Thomas, we wouldn't have a TV show. He made a huge impact on our childhood, and that's why I think he deserves an honorable mention, at least. But now it's time to go to the number one pick. And my number one favorite Thomas the Friends character is Edward. I freaking love Edward. His character is just so great. He's a kind old engine, but somewhat underrated. And these traits allow him for some pretty great episodes. He has some of the best episodes in the entire series. Like we've got Old Iron, A Cow on the Line, Edward the Really Useful Engine, and my all-time favorite episode, Edward's Exploit. Good God, that is one of the best episodes I have ever seen in any TV show for that matter. And I also love how consistent he is. Like, even in the CGI series, he still maintains a lot of his character. Well, I mean, okay, he did have a couple of bad episodes in the new series, but he was still kind of enjoyable to an extent. He also has one of the best music themes out there, with my favorite being his Season 2 track, but I also really love his Season 6, his original, and even the new series theme. He's just, in my opinion, a perfect Thomas and Friends character, and that is why he is number one on my list. So that's going to be all for this video, guys. Be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know in the comments what you thought of this video. But that's all for now, guys. This is the Blue OJ Leader, and I'll see you later.